the November episode of Husky Vision.
We hope you all had a great Thanksgiving break and everyone is ready for the last few weeks of the school semester.
Let's start out today with a visit with the girls and boys basketball teams. We visited with the 8th grade players about their expectations for the team.
Hey, I'm here with
Landon Kovac,
Isaac Shadle,
Isaiah Towie.
And we're going to be asking them some questions. Do you guys know when your guys' first game will be?
Next Monday.
What is your number?
My number is 35.
12.
34.
How was tryouts?
I guess it was good because we made the team.
Yeah, it was pretty good. It's a lot of work.
Yeah, fun.
Were you happy when you made the team?
Yes, I was happy.
Yeah, I was pretty happy.
Very.
What's the most fun thing about basketball so far this year?
I'm really getting to know each other and work as a team and see how we're improving as a team.
Working with all these great athletes.
Same thing.
Back to the studios.
Hi, I'm Maya McVeigh, and I'm here with
Coach Allen.
And we're going to ask him a few questions. So, when is your first game?
Our first game is on Monday, the 21st. Our first game is a road game. It is at Smith Hale Middle School, which is in South Kansas City. Starts at 4 o'clock.
And how is your season going so far?
So far, we're looking pretty good, I hope. We've got some good athletes. Boys are really working hard. I'm pretty optimistic about the year so far.
And what's your favorite part about coaching?
With this group in particular, I really like I said, we've got some really good athletes. Some guys are really coachable. They're taking all the coaching really well. We haven't had a ton of success the last couple of years. So, like I said, I'm really optimistic about hopefully having a lot better year this year.
This has been Maya McVeigh. Back to you.
Games started last week, so good luck to all of our Husky teams out on the court.
Now it's time to check out our latest episodes of Two Truths and a Lie.
Remember, you can play along and try to figure out which statements are true and which one is a lie.
Hi, I'm here with Mrs. Bresky, and we are doing the Two Truths and One Lie.
Hi, are you guys ready? I live next door to my parents. I swam with a barracuda. I am a foster parent.
What do you guys think?
I do live next door to my parents. We bought our house first. I did swim with a barracuda. I scuba dove and saw a barracuda, unfortunately for me, because I was scared. And I was a foster parent, but after we adopted our 3 children, we let our license expire. So I am no longer a foster parent.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm Rianne Fitterling, and I'm doing 2 Truths and 1 Lie with Mr. Laws.
I have bowled in 3 professional tournaments, one being in Barcelona, Spain. My favorite Halloween costume as a kid was Richard Dawes. For those of you that don't know, he was the other rider with Paul Revere. And then I was a finalist for the Charno Award, which is the outstanding senior at CMSU my senior year in college.
What do you think?
And my lie would be my favorite Halloween costume as a kid was Richard Dawes. I don't even know who the guy is.
Cold and flu season is in full swing, Huskies.
We have some reminders about how to keep yourself and others healthy this winter so you can be staying strong.
Hi, I'm Avery Pennington.
And I'm McKenna Flores.
And we're going to show you how to incorrectly and correctly wash your hands. Let's start with incorrectly. Basketball practice with Mr. Middleton. gosh, we're gonna be late. And now we're going to show you how to correctly wash your hands. First, turn on the water. Then get soap in your hands. One squirt of soap.
Wash hands for 20 seconds.
One, two, three, 20.
Rinse hands. Three pumps of paper towels.
And throw away in the trash can without trying to shoot any poops. Then, even if you're late, you're going to slowly walk out of the bathroom by putting one foot in front of the other. And just keep doing that until you get to your class.
So,
gross.
Do it right. Take one tissue at a time and throw it in the trash can. Make sure you get hand sanitizer when you're done.
Don't fail, it's not worth your life, bro.
Just remember, cough and sneeze in your arm to protect.
What are your favorite Thanksgiving foods and traditions?
Our crew has found out that people have a wide variety of favorites for this time of year.
Good morning, Huskyville. We're here during sixth grade lunch talking about Thanksgiving, which Thanksgiving break actually starts tomorrow. I know you're watching this later, but question of the day for this group is your favorite Thanksgiving meal.
Well, I got ham. Ham, turkey, mac and cheese, everything. Cornbread. Ham's my favorite though. Turkey second, mac and cheese third. I keep on going on all day. Fourth, cornbread. I'll let him go.
Turkey and mashed potatoes.
Turkey and yams.
Turkey and mashed potatoes.
Anything they'll let me eat. Minus squash.
Cheese and potatoes, turkey, blah, blah, blah.
Cheesy mashed potatoes and turkey.
Turkey and mashed potatoes with gravy.
All right, Huskyville, we're still here with sixth grade lunch talking about if anybody has travel plans for Thanksgiving. I personally get to stay in town. Normally I travel to Iowa, and I'm so excited I don't have to drive. So I am staying in town with my family.
Yes. Wales.
I'm staying at home.
I'm going to my grandpa's house.
I'm staying at home.
I'm staying at home.
I'm staying at my grandparents' house.
I'm staying home.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen. We're here with the second lunch shift. The question of this lunch shift happens to be, what is your favorite pie for Thanksgiving?
Go ahead and hold that.
Cherry.
Mine's pumpkin.
Blueberry.
Apple.
Pumpkin.
3.145.
Good morning, folks. We are still with the second lunch shift. The question for this group of girls is your favorite dessert that you will have this Thanksgiving?
Pie. Apple pie.
I love ice cream.
Chocolate upside down cake.
Hi, we have two more girls here that's going to explain what their favorite food is for Thanksgiving.
My favorite food is stuffing.
My favorite food is probably potatoes. Potatoes beat everything.
And now I'm hungry.
Good morning once again, Huskyville. We are with the third lunch shift today, and their question happens to be their favorite Thanksgiving food of any kind.
Cherry pie.
Hold on. You can pull the pets. There
you. Cherry pie.
Bread.
Mine's green bean casserole with bacon.
Mine's peach cobbler.
Stuffing.
Pecan pie.
Stuffing.
Sugar cookies.
So last month, we did a candy challenge.
This month, we decided to play Will It Donut. Let's head to the challenge and see how our participants did.
Here to interview Emma, Ty, and Charlie to see if it will donut. The first topping is ketchup. Will it donut?
No.
I will say yes, finally.
Well, that looks pretty disgusting. So, now we are going to try green beans on this glazed donut. Will it donut?
Yeah. Yeah. Terrible.
I didn't expect that.
Thai.
Oh, no, yeah.
The most disgusting thing I've ever tried.
I'm in the
blender. Thai, how in the world? Oh my gosh, I hate green beans.
Get a little more bite.
Who has thought of this?
What are you?
Hi, and now we are going to do whipped cream. Will it donut?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. What do you think?
Yeah.
Did you know that MRMS has its own cheer club?
They work hard to prepare a cheer routine to perform at our winter sports assembly.
I'm Eddie Andrews.
And I'm Marissa Tebow.
And we're interviewing your MRMS cheerleaders. What's your favorite part about cheer?
My favorite part about cheer is that we get to have fun as an after-school activity. And I love hanging out with Misty, and she's awesome. And I love cheering in front of people.
My favorite part about cheer is getting to be with friends, having fun, and just making up a bunch of weird stuff that
you can have fun. Think about it.
How long do you guys do? Half an hour, 45 minutes.
I think they're 45 minutes, and we usually do them in the morning. Today is like our second practice after school, but
how many days a week do you practice for cheer?
Usually twice. We do it on Mondays, usually on Fridays.
Okay. Is cheer fun, and would you recommend it?
Absolutely. Yeah. You need to like get your groove on. It's so much fun. I mean, unless you're like stage fright, because when you go like and perform, it's kind of okay.
Thank you
for the.
Our fall play, Game of TRS, was a smashing success, enjoyed by all grade levels at school day shows, and 3 shows open to the public.
Our crews talked to some of the members of the cast to find out their thoughts about being a part of the production.
Hi, I'm Joey Collins interviewing.
Xander Corkins.
Quinn Sanders.
Anna Miller.
Lily Gartman.
And I'm Avery Pennington, and I'm also interviewing these people. So, what has been the hardest thing for you in the play? Trying to get the effect on people's faces.
Trying not to laugh on stage.
Learning all my lines and then like not laughing when other people are talking.
Trying not to turn the spotlight in random scenes.
So what would be your favorite scene in the play?
Oh, I have to say the murder scene.
Probably the scene where I die.
I also really like it when I die because it's fun.
I just like all the scenes, but if I had to do a particular, I like the Schmeagol scenes.
Hi, I'm Joey Collins interviewing.
Mrs. Small.
Savannah Justice.
And I'm Avery Pennington, and I'm helping interview these people. What has been your favorite part about the play or helping with the play?
My favorite part about like being in the play is like just all the people that are in it and how many people you get to meet, because they're all like so amazing.
I love working on the plays. This is my 10th year costuming the show. It's been a real challenge, but it's always fun. I love working with the kids. I think that's the very best part of it.
And what would you say is your like your favorite scene?
My favorite scene. I think it's when Ariel is talking about her thingamabobs. I don't know, it just makes me giggle.
I love the animated snowman scene because it's just so amazing. It's really funny.
Thank you for your time.
Every holiday season, MRMS participates in grade level and Stuco clothing and food drives to help people in our community who need a hand.
We talked to Mrs. Strako about this year's events and how you can help.
Hi, I'm Maya McVeigh, and I am here with
Mrs. Strako.
And we're going to ask her about this Christmas project. So, can you tell us a little about the 8th grade project?
The 8th grade project is one we're really proud of. Want me to hold that? Okay. We are going to get gifts for the Community Services League Adolescent Christmas Store. You know, everybody likes to buy baby dolls and trucks, but nobody likes to buy for the teenagers, and so that's what we do. In the next week, all of our kids will have an opportunity to pick a light bulb off of our bulletin board. Each light bulb has a different gift on it. They'll be asked to return that gift, and we will give it to the Community Services League holiday store, and they will be going to needy families in the Blue Springs area. We also, pack by pack, will be putting together two holiday dinners. Each pack will be asked to bring in all the fixins for a holiday meal, and then we will be adding, we've made a little money on the side through this project and through others, we will be, and through Headphone Day, and we will be giving each of the dinner boxes a grocery card so they can go and buy their turkey or ham or whatever perishables they need. So we do gifts and dinner boxes for the 8th grade.
And is there any more information on the student council?
Student council will be holding from December 12th through the 16th a holiday store during lunch in the cafeteria. We'll be selling little bits of candy, and with each 25-cent purchase, you'll be able to also get a chance to win a raffle or a prize in a raffle. So far, we've got tickets to the Comets and Royals, and we're going to have candy and all sorts of great raffle prizes that you can win. And those will be going out December 12th through the 16th. All of the money from that project goes to the counselors Adopt a Family, which also helps a needy family in the Blue Springs, Moreland Ridge area.
Thank you. This has been Maya McVeigh.
You're welcome.
And that is it for this episode of Husky Vision. We hope you have enjoyed the show.
See you next month for another great episode of Husky Vision. Dun 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 dun